bird was busted. She buried her nose in no man's land a half mile due west of where I went down. Wilson, the poor sap, didn't make it out. But that was his bad luck. I had more pressing problems. I'm just gonna say I've had plenty of practice moving quietly. Out the back of bars, bedroom windows, you don't need the details. Anyway, once those Germans were gone, I put my skills to work, heading west towards the British front, quiet as an alley cat. Between me and the British front were German trenches and German guns. Oh, and half the population of Berlin, all spoiling for a fight. My lucky day. The Brits must have been sitting down for tea and crumpets instead of shelling the Germans. Still, I had to get through to our side of the line before those guns started up again. Thank you. Those trenches were packed full of the Kaiser's finest. But hopefully, most of them would be looking for trouble coming the other way. Hopefully. A dozen German machine guns at my back kinda encouraged me to keep my head down. No Man's Land was a maze of barbed wire, dead bodies, and debris. But I held my course. Did anything survive the crash that might be useful?
Your bleeding word. So either you're a decent bloke who's gonna help me, or you're a lying, no good bastard who look me in the eye and finish it. Come on, which is it? Put your cards on the table, Blackburn. You're not George Rackham, are you? Son of the fourth bloody Earl of Windsor. How naive do you think I am?
Let's get out of here. I was losing a lot of blood. I didn't have much time to get him back alive.
God almighty! Look! German Raiders moving into our lines!
The Germans aren't really known for giving up. They did everything they could to catch us.
Trained on them. They shoot anything. We made it!